Calling all stations. Clear the air lanes. Clear all air lanes for the big broadcast.
Captain's Log, summer 1984. Backed by a crew of 45 winners who successfully completed the sentence, "My summer is so miserable that..."
Bah, humbug!
We set out on a sunny afternoon from beneath Michigan Avenue and beneath your dignity on Sven's summer sail.
Everybody, thank you all for showing. These are our lucky winners here. Let's hear it for yourselves, won't you? These are all the lucky winners for our Sven summer sail. Here we are next to the beautiful, scenic, and aromatic Chicago River. And we're going to be going on a cruise here. You'll be seeing the highlights right here on this program, plus a wacky movie. It's The Invasion of the Star Creatures with these big, tall girls and these scary carrot monsters. It could only occur on this program. So we're getting set for the invasion of the star creatures. We're ready for the cruise, so come on, let's go. Yeah, let's go. No. Wait a minute. No. Don't. Wait, no.
Gentlemen, we're about to embark on a very momentous journey. Personally, I'm proud to be part of it.
The picture the world has been waiting to see.
Defense. Here at Fort Nicholson is found the world's center of atomic research. Here the world's greatest scientists are working together to build and experiment with the atomic and hydrogen weapons that make this country the strongest force for peace in the world. Each man here is a hand-picked expert.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
Howdy doody time, it's howdy doody time. What are you trying to do, drown me or something? You and your bright ideas.
Well, we joined the Army for adventure, didn't we?
Not me. I joined the Army to get an education. You know, chicks go for intellectual guys these days. Remember them army posters? Join the army. Let us prepare you for a high-paying civilian job.
I knew how to be a civilian before I ever joined the army.
What have we learned so far? What have we learned so far?
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you one thing we learned. Never to volunteer.
We don't have to. Every dirty job in the army is our personal property.
Yeah? Well, how about discipline? Weren't we taught discipline?
How do I know? I can't even spell it.
Neatness. How about neatness?
Cleaning garbage cans.
Yeah, well... Yeah, that's for sure. Hmm. How can you eat that stuff?
It ain't easy.
Hey, Philbrick. I wonder what kind of a high-paying civilian job they're preparing us for.
Well, Penno, buddy, I don't know from anyone at the city dump. We might make a couple of good sanitary engineers.
Come on, you never pass that sanitary part.
The way I figure it, missiles are the thing. We ought to transfer to a missile base.
No, Brick, this is a missile base.
Well, then we ought to ask for action. Things are happening up there. This is a space age. I want to go to the moon.
Yeah, and I'd like to send you there.
I'm serious. Look at Sputnik.
Sputnik? You mean Sputnik.
Yeah. They sent a dog up in one. The next thing is to send a man. I'd volunteer.
You said a man.
Private Philbrick, first man into space. I ain't so big. I'd probably fit in one of those satellites. How big do you think they are?
I'd say about the size of one of them GI cans.
Hold my cigar.
Hey, Philbrick! Philbrick!
Over here, Pat.
Where?
In here.
Not bad. It's a little cramped.
Boy, you sure look natural in there.
Shut it out!
All right, Commander Philbrick. Are you all set to go?
Check, Commander Penn. Ready for camera check. Ready for instrument check.
Pressure?
Check, check, check.
Ready for blast off? Countdown.
10, 9, 8, 7, oxygen, 6, 5, 4, new arm, 3, recording tape on, 2, 1, blast off!
Yeah! Hey, man, what's going on here? Like, man, what's happening?
Take me to your leader.
Man, you're really swinging. Where were you headed?
For the moon.
Yeah, what's playing?
Where is it?
Where's what?
The moon.
Man, I don't know. This ain't my neighborhood.
Oh! Hey, crazy, man. Crazy. I don't know you dance.
Hey, listen, both you cats, both gonna be way out if you don't get over to Colonel's office.
The colonel?
That's right, Dad. The big bird, the way the eagle flies, he wants to see you. So let's get with it, because I'm your sergeant. You know what I mean? Come on, man. 1, 2, 3, 4, that's it.
2, 3, 4.
Something smells like burnt feathers.
Colonel, those two soldiers are here.
Hey, Penn, I wonder what the colonel wants with us.
I don't know. Maybe he's going to make you a guided missile.
I bet it's that big job he's got for us. The operation they kept secret till now. Maybe they're going to send us to Moscow on a secret mission. Or maybe to the Pentagon.
Yeah, you read too many space comics. Nothing ever happens to a private. I'd be happy if we get one stripe.
I'd rather have a medal.
Yeah, you'll probably get one, too. A lump with a black and blue cluster on it.
Okay, you space jockeys, come on in here.
And remember, no matter what they accuse us of, we didn't do it. Capiche?
Okay, you men. The colonel's gonna say something important.
Something smells like burnt chicken.
I'm gonna get you for impersonating an officer yet.
Quiet and right.
Hello, Now, you men know why you're here.
No, no, of course you don't. How could you? Stop security. But I'll be brief. If there's anything I like, it's a brief briefing. No shilly-shallying around or beating around the bush. I like to set my sights on the target, take aim, and get to the point. What's the point? Oh, yes. Top secret. Nick concerns. Concerns.
Sergeant, what's the concern?
Oh, yes. That's real top secret. Even I couldn't remember it. But I remember one time during the war.
Which war, sir?
Well, let's see. What war is this? Never mind. This is a mission that demands the utmost secrecy. What I have to say is vital to this nation's very existence. In other words,
hey, fellas!
And that's why it's got to be a secret. You hear me?
If you're a bell, sir, you're coming in loud and clear. The mission, sir.
Oh, yes. Gentlemen, oh, I'm sorry. No, I didn't mean that. No offense, men. I know how touchy you enlisted men are. But you're the backside of the Army, and don't you forget it. Now, I forgot it. What was I going to say?
The mission, sir.
Sergeant, why do you keep repeating that? Missy. Oh, yes. 2 weeks ago, men, this area was shaken by the worst explosion ever created by man. A really big blast. The United States government detonated this most powerful type nuclear bomb right here at Nicholson Mesa. Get the point?
It's a good one, sir.
We've been waiting 2 weeks, gentlemen, for radioactive dust and fallout to clear, so that our Army reconnaissance planes can cover the blast area and determine the extent of the nuclear devastation.
You stand still.
Well, men, those planes went in there yesterday and took aerial photographs. And it was a holocaust. You can see this is really a dangerous mission.
Hey, I don't think he likes me.
What do you mean he don't like you? He missed you, didn't he?
The crater is 5 miles in diameter and almost 1/2 mile deep. And men, do you know what that means? It's a big hole. And the photograph showed in one particular area of the crater what appears to be a huge cave, evidently exposed to the blast. It has intelligence stumped. They want to know what it is and how it got there. Men, they want us to find out what that cave is. In other words, we've got to get in there and... Sorry, man. Didn't do any damage. Hit the mess hall. Up on your feet. That brings me to your assignment.
The mission, sir.
Sergeant, I know you're a man of few words, but you have to keep using those same words over and over again. Get an army of your own. I know what I'm doing. What was I doing? Oh, yes. The mission. Why didn't you think of that? What do you think I keep you around for? Men, you've all been selected to go into this area and investigate that cave and report your findings to me. You men have been selected because your specific aptitudes and training have made you the best qualified men on this base for your particular job.
Vic, I'm over here. Would you put the camera on me? Vic, would you... You know, lots of frigate crashers have shown up here to try to get on board. Why, even famous White Sox star Ron Kittle tried to get on disguised as a fish.
Look at that strong gill structure. I'm not a bad-looking fish at that.
A vast new barnacles, or whatever, a vast group of people were ready to board the ship here. And I just want to make sure everybody who's getting on belongs here. Sir, what is your name?
Dave Stupel.
His name is Hello, my name is. And what was your entry in the contest?
My summer was so miserable because just the other night, my dog ran away and my wife came back.
Okay, and madam, do you have anything to declare before you go on?
Oh, yeah, he's a pain.
Oh, that's his wife. I'm sorry. Okay, please continue on. And you, sir, what's your name?
Bucky Price.
And Bucky, what was your entry?
My summer was so miserable that my fish learned to swim on their side, my dog drools,
and my parrot turned to Jesus and talks like Jerry Falwell.
Oh, get on the boat. Hey, well, Dan, come here. Dan, what, Dan Orshansky?
Yes, right.
And what was your entry?
My summer is so miserable that my only vacation was my... I kept on wrong bus to summer school and wound up in Berwyn.
Berwyn? Wait a minute. What are you talking about? And your name is covered by your hair.
Oh,
Ashley, yes.
Else.
What was your entry, Ashley?
My summer is so miserable that I'd rather be gagged twice over with the serving spoon.
Like, for sure. Thank you. Okay, get on here, yes. And next, obviously, this man does not want to speak to me. Yes, Cheryl, what was your entry?
My summer is so lousy that at my surprise birthday party, nobody bothered to invite me.
Rimshot. Okay, thank you. And if we better load up here. Scott, come here. Scott, hi. What was your entry in our contest?
My summer is so miserable that I went on vacation to the Grand Canyon and it was closed for repairs.
Well, keep going. Okay, and Mick, come here. Mick, what was your entry in our contest?
My summer is so miserable that I wish I could sing like Harry Smiller.
Well, try it.
In the good old...
Rockabye, your baby.
Yeah, you got no problem. You sound just like him. And, sir, come here. And what was your winning entry here on the cruise?
I bought this just for this stupid boat ride. You know.
But, Doug, but get on there. Who asked you? And now here's me. Say hi, me.
Hi, me.
Okay, good. Keep going. All right, well, get on the... Excuse me, Holly, what was your entry in the cruise contest?
I wolf down, man. Too many francs and steins of Drac Cola and gained 50 pounds. It was the pits and the spindle drum.
Okay, yeah. These are the winners? Okay, well, please, you work here. Get on board. And by the way, now, if there's any trouble, Nevin, I want him to take care of everything, okay?
Okay.
Okay, no, now, look at the camera and say, roll the commercials.
What a commercial.
He's a star. Okay, get on the boat. We're going. Come on.
Touch me. Touch me.
And your new General Electric refrigerator won't show fingerprints.
Touch me. Touch me.
There's extra room in the new Space Maker door.
Touch me. Touch me.
For a six-pack, two-liter bottle.
Touch me. Touch me.
Even a half gallon of ice cream. And the snugger helps keep small things in place.
Touch me. Touch me.
And you touch GE features in the refrigerator with the right touch.
Available at Polk.
Happy. I know.
The best First Metropolitan customer is an informed customer, and that's why we like to show you how we build or repair something. Like this well-worn porch. We begin by removing the old porch. Then we add the posts and beams. Next, we add the joists, flooring, and steps. Finally, we add the rails, and you have a beautiful new porch at sensible prices. Call now for a free estimate. 282-8600. First Metropolitan, building with Chicagoland for over 30 years.
Burger King presents a breakfast challenge to muffin lovers, the Burger King Crust Sandwich. See if you can resist our grade A eggs covered with melted cheese, our sizzling bacon, tender ham, or sausage. Come on, muffin lovers, take just a nibble of the most delicious breakfast sandwich imaginable.
Aren't you hungry? Aren't you hungry?
The Burger King Crust Sandwich. Even for a confirmed muffin lover, it's love at first bite.
Aren't you hungry for Burger King now?
Here on Empire Shelves is the same top-line brand-name carpeting the stores in town will sell you. But you see, what they have to send away for, we have in stock, right in our warehouse. So you get it in 72 hours instead of 4 to 6 weeks. And don't forget, you also get your choice of a Bissell rug shampooer or a push-button telephone, absolutely free. Hey, you guys came to get me down, huh?
Uh-uh. 588-2300-EMPIRE.
Back to Invasion of the Star Creatures as we mention our favorite winning entries.
Like Jim Concannon's, my summer is so miserable, not only do bullies kick sand in my face, but so do the girls.
Geiger counter reading, Daddy. What kind of rhythm you getting?
Nothing, Sergeant.
What's that buzzing jazz then, Harris?
probably that rattlesnake you're stepping on.
Oh, yeah, the snake! Ah! Hey, like, what are you doing? Like, wow!
I killed him!
You came on like gangbusters, Prez. He might have bit me. You're right.
I never killed anything before.
You saved my life. Don't that mean nothing?
They gave me a gun. I'm not a killer.
Why?
Why did it have to be this way? I didn't even know him.
Turn it off, killer. It was only a snake. What's wrong with killing a snake?
He might have had a family.
Man, you real people.
Come on.
Stop, please. We're entering the contaminated area. Put your gas mask on, please.
Sergeant said to keep our gas mask on.
They can't tell me what to do during my lunch hour.
Maybe you're right.
Here's okay, Sergeant. We can take this gear off.
As I was saying, Sergeant, this is indigenous rock. This cave has been here a long time. It definitely was not formed by the blast.
Hey, Glory! I found something over here you want to look at. I've never seen anything like it.
What a strange-looking cat. Like it's not human. How do you dig it, boy?
Definitely not a man, but a humanoid, I'd say. There's no evidence of fossilization. 7 feet tall, at least. And skin formation seems to consist of woody tissue or bark.
See, or whatever it is radioactive. Must have been killed by the blast.
Yeah, but like, where did it come from? Even my relatives don't look like that. Wow.
An extraterrestrial, perhaps.
You're right. Like if I knew what you meant.
Oh, it's simple. I merely surmise this creature may have come from another planet.
Yeah, real simple, Prez. Only how'd he get here and dead yet?
Well, you're gonna have my share of any live ones, you see.
Okay, men, we gotta do the right thing. We gotta do the hero bit and check this jazz out. First, we'll do the combat routine, like weapons ready and spread out, you dig? And secondly, if you men find anything, let me in on it, because like I'm the sergeant, you know what I mean? Okay, men, let's move out. Come on. Two, three, four.
Philbrick, that was the greatest. I don't want to be a killjoy, Philbrick, but how did you manage to get all that food, that extra food in your Vel pack?
That was easy. I left out a couple of boxes.
Boxes? What kind of boxes?
Those heavy metal ones.
Did they have dials on them and tubes and wires on the inside?
Yeah, those were the ones.
Fine. You left the radio behind.
So who's got time to listen to the radio? Relax already.
Relax.
Philbrick, cut out that snoring, will you? You drive me crazy.
Yeah. When it comes to absorbency, Viva's more than a paper towel. Watch. To be precise, it's a paper sponge. It may sound incredible, but Viva absorbs as much as this sponge. So Viva can sponge up your sloppiest spills, sponge up your trippiest drips. Incredibly absorbent Viva, the paper towel that's really a paper sponge.
When First Metropolitan Builders remodels or repairs your home, you can almost pick the payment plan you want, $20, $30, $100 a month. For instance, if you need some repairs or remodeling and it costs $1,200, you can pay as little as $2,904 a month. Or if your kitchen needs an overhaul and the bill comes to $1,800, pay just $43.56 a month. Find out today. Call 282-8600 for a free estimate. First Metropolitan Builders, 282-8600.
Feel like you're part of the Olympic action. Play McDonald's. When the U.S. wins, you win Olympic games.
It's your event here.
Boxing. If the U.S. wins, then I win.
When the U.S. wins a medal in the event on your game card, you win a Big Mac. Or regular fries. Or regular Coca-Cola. Or win up to $10,000 instantly. So go to McDonald's and collect your game cards, because when the U.S. wins, hey, you win.
I'm in training.
Oh.
Katie? You okay?
Lucky I finished cleaning before the lights went out.
I can tell. My house never smelled so clean before.
That's the pine salt signal. That fresh scent says more than clean.
How come?
Because pine salt cleaner disinfectant cuts through grease, kills household germs and odors,
and leaves a fresh scent that says more than clean, even with the lights out.
The Pine Sol signal tells the world your house is more than clean.
Aggressive. The dictionary defines it as bold, active, enterprising. These terms define Rudy Law, the aggressive outfielder who demonstrates the true meaning of the word with his style of play. Whether it's getting the extra jump on a ball to center field or grabbing that extra base to set up a run.
Sometimes that extra effort makes a difference in a ball game. Look for the Sox to get that extra effort Monday night at 7:30 against the Milwaukee Brewers on Channel 32.
Back to Invasion of the Star Creatures and Tombstone's favorite entry.
Well, it's Stephen Hashioka who said, "My summer's so miserable, I've been chosen official javelin catcher at the Summer Olympics."
Philbrick! Philbrick! Yes, Ken? I think I'm having you dream about the monsters. It's terrible. It's awful. Well, I'm having you dream about the Thames, and it's terrible, terrible, terrible.
What's so terrible about dreaming about Thames?
In my dream, I'm stuck to a table and can't move. It's terrible, terrible, terrible.
I don't think we're dreaming. I think all this is for real.
Well, what are we going to do?
I don't think we have much choice.
I wonder what Space Commander Connors would do in a situation like this. I bet he'd bust these straps, capture these freaks, take them to Washington for questioning.
Yeah, well, too bad you ain't Space Commander Connors.
I am Professor Tango. This is my assistant, Dr. Puna. We are from the planet Kalar, the Belfar star system, approximately 600 million light years away.
Hey, are there any more like you on the planet, baby?
Baby?
How come you speak our language so well?
It's quite simple. We have an electrophophalographalahophimetic.
Oh, what?
It's a device which transfers the knowledge of one brain into the proper symbols for explanation in another one.
Hey, you lost me right there, baby.
I told you they're primitive.
Hey, now, hold on a minute. That means dumb, don't it?
That's right, Daddy-O. You're real square.
Hey, this chick is hip.
That was just some of the crude expressions we assimilated from one of your fellow natives.
Sergeant Glory. Well, tell us, how do you do it?
We'll demonstrate.
While I'm here, you might as well give me a finger wave.
Yeah, and give me a trim.
Quiet. All of your thoughts, knowledge, impressions, skills, and conditioning, both conscious and subconscious, will be transmitted through this brain machine into picture symbols on the screen above. In a few minutes, we can completely assimilate all the knowledge it took you a lifetime to acquire. It's like a recording tape from which we can extract and edit only the information that we desire.
I'm not so sure I like you, knowing everything I've done.
Don't flatter yourself. We're not interested in your primitive emotions. We're scientists.
Yeah, and all I can say, baby, you got some mighty good-looking equipment.
You will be the first. In a few minutes, we will see what you have stored within your brain. That's odd, it's a blank.
I could have told you that.
There seems to be a mechanical failure, Dr. Puna. Try yours. Look at me. Look at me. Now tell me exactly what you're thinking. Look closely now. Dr. Puna, remember our mission and who you are.
Just what is your mission?
We are here on your Earth as a scientific investigating team. We've been here for 10 of your years, but our work is about completed.
We would have left before, but our ship was badly damaged in landing, and we've had to make extensive repairs.
Hey, baby, you're really out of this world.
Our planet is a small one, and overpopulation has forced us into seeking a new world for our people. Our duty has been to find one and discover if it could be conquered and by what means. You'd be surprised how simple it's going to be.
I wouldn't mind being conquered by someone like you. But tell me, how come you girls are so good-looking and your boyfriend so handsome? Or ain't they human?
We'll show you. Come along.
Keep your carrot-kicking hands off me.
Hey, Silbridge, are you all right?
Yeah.
But you know something, Penn?
No, what?
That's the first time a salad ever tossed me.
Three times the softness in April freshness. A cap that doesn't drip. Low price, too?
Impossible.
That's what women said when we filled this handy little bottle with all the softness and April freshness of this bottle three times the size. Introducing new triple concentrated Downy with three times the softness and April freshness in every drop. A new no-drip cap, and it costs less than regular Downy.
Can it work like my Downy?
Sure, with one-third as much.
Same Downy softness, same April freshness.
Love this cap. It doesn't drip. All that? And costs less, too?
Incredible!
April Fresh Downy. Regular and new money-saving triple concentrated.
Have you ever been ashamed of your white shirt? Ashamed of your white shirt?
Or ashamed your white are a sight?
Then get Oxidol and you won't get ashamed to show it white.
Hey, Oxidol knows dingy whites are embarrassing, so it has hard-working cleaners and the color-safe bleach. Now look, this kid's socks were muddied a bunch of times and washed each time in a leading liquid. The same with these, but washed each time in Oxidol. Your kids wouldn't be ashamed to wear the Oxidol socks, because they're whiter.
So let's see that shirt.
Yay!
Your shorts are out of sight. Aren't you proud of your white? Yeah, with Oxidol, you won't get ashamed to show it white.
Buy custom-made draperies and slipcovers from the specialist and save up to 50%. By calling 745-3800, our specialists will come to your home with colors, patterns, and styles that you think would cost twice the price. Quilted valances, upholstered cornices, and festoons. Many blinds, vertical blinds, woven wood, shades. We have it all. At savings up to 50%, call 745-3800. Buy direct from the specialist. Call 745-3800 for a free home estimate.
We have excitement. We have stars. We have surprises. And we have the 50 most beautiful married women in America. One of them will be crowned Mrs. America 1984.
I don't joke, but who cares? Did you receive the letters? Please, please, not one of the children.
Friday at 8.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the Sven Summer Sail vehicle. We call it a boat in the business, but you people are too young to know about that kind of stuff. Now, if you'll watch your steward and stewardess behind me, you'll find out exactly about the safety precautions on the boat. First of all, as we cross under a bridge here, no, it's not an eclipse of the sun. Here we are, and ladies and gentlemen, first of all, remember, if you'll check under your seat, you will find an inflatable rubber chicken. In the event that we begin to sink, please reach under your seat, as they are showing you now, and simply take out the inflatable rubber chicken. Pull his leg. Ah, you're pulling my leg. And he will inflate thusly. Then, when the chicken is inflated, throw it overboard and pray, because it's not going to help you anyway. Now, you will also notice directly above you the sky. In the event that oxygen gets scarce, try to reach that as soon as possible. And I think that... doing a fine job back here, aren't you? Sure. Okay. So remember, please, keep these safety ideas in mind. The boat is accelerating rapidly because it's going to be lunchtime now. You'll be receiving your absolutely free and delicious lunch, which Guglia will be providing to you. So please, stay tuned and be prepared for more fun here on Sven's Summer Sail. Thank you. Thank you.
Bye. An experiment that should never have happened 41 years ago.
We opened up a hole in time, and it stayed open.
Is still going on. Good Lord, there it is. And the only survivor of a journey through time is the only hope for the future.
Now, we can't stop it, but I believe that you can.
Go!
The Philadelphia Experiment, rated PG.
Now playing. Consult your local newspaper.
If you're looking for new furniture, no one beats the values at Furniture Outlet Sales. You can't beat our best-selling four-piece living room group with sofa, loveseat, chair, and ottoman, only $149. You can't beat our five-piece pine group for only $199. And there's no beating our price of only $299 on this beautiful 10-piece play pit group. Plus, ask for a giant Michael Jackson pillow, free with any deluxe living room group. For prices that can't be beat, beat it down to Furniture Outlet Sales. 7414 South Cicero, Ford City West, behind Aldi's.
Here, take a look at this. You can see the extra cushion of foam insulation. Now, think of the difference it'll mean in dollars that you save in fuel. This is Stratowall siding by U.S. Steel All Side from First Metropolitan Builders. And it's got another benefit, an energy-saving tax rebate. Call 282-8600 right now for a free estimate. 24-hour phone service, suburbs within 50 miles call collect. First Metropolitan, building with Chicago for 30 years.
So shiny.
You let your joy show in the things you do, so let our joy flow. Watch that shine come through, you'll see your flakes glow. People notice them too, our joy's the reason.
Watch, other leading brands can dry leaving dirty looking spots. Only Joy's Lemon Fresh formula lets dishes dry clean, practically spot free, down to the shine.
Our joy's the reason, let your joy show.
Today at 5:30, it's another episode of Too Close for Comfort.
Cosmic Cow loses her memory.
Why not?
Henry's new story has a surprise plot twist.
Come into the bedroom.
Animal.
Let's go.
I can't wait to see how it ends.
Too Close for Comfort. Today at 5:30 on Metro Media 32. Back to Invasion of the Star Creatures. And what's Guglia Child's favorite entry?
It's Regina Andrews who said, "My summer is so miserable, I want to put some eggs under my feet and beat it!"
Big guys are nothing but plants, and you grow them right here in these pots?
Wow! And all these plants are nothing but men?
In physical appearance, they are male. Why?
Nothing. I just thought you might have a tomato or two clinging on the vine somewhere.
Hey, that would be great. You don't have a seed catalog, do you, for chicks, babes, you know, dolls?
Are women all you think of?
Well, not always.
Good. What else?
Girl.
We brought the soil from our planet. The Vegemen used to grow wild in our world, and if we had not destroyed their leaders and confined their growth to our pastures, they would have wiped out our culture.
Wow, with all this dirt, we could run vitamins out of business.
They do all our menial labor, the hard work.
Hey, Philbrick, these guys are just like us. They're nothing but yard birds.
When they are mature, we remove them from the soil. They're almost indestructible, but their lifespan is quite short.
Can they talk?
No, they are telepathic, so that we give them orders by thought or by verbal communication. But, come along. We have something else to show you.
Pull yourself together, fellas. We'll be right back. Starship.
It operates on a time warp drive. We do not travel through time, but around it. Do you understand?
I don't, but maybe he does. He got a warp mind. Funny man. I may be dying and you're making jokes.
Well, we joined the army for adventure, didn't we?
If I get out of this, I'll stick to comic books.
What is comic books?
It's our army tech manual.
The last task of our present crop of Vegemen will be to prepare the ship for launching and fire it from this room. We must hold you two Earthmen in our force field unit for the time being, while we make final preparations to take off.
Force field unit? What's that?
A sort of cage. But instead of bars, you'll be retained by an electrical force barrier.
Where?
Right here. Look at them. They are primitive.
Yes, but they're human.
I've been meaning to talk to you. I think you're getting much too involved emotionally with these creatures.
I'm a scientist.
Well, remember your duty then and act like one.
Only
what?
It's been so long since we've seen any men.
And a good thing, too. Stupid, arrogant, braggart. All of them with their illusion of superiority.
But scientifically, they are necessary.
I must remind you of your oath. The one you took when you entered the scientific service. You promised to uphold our principles.
I had no idea they'd be so dull.
You're suffering from a slight touch of space fever. Once we blast off and head for home, you'll be all right. All you actually feel for these creatures is pity. They've stimulated your maternal instincts. Come along.
Perhaps you're right, Doctor, but I wonder what they think of us.
I'm hungry. Is that all you think about us, food? We better try to figure out what those king-sized female Einsteins are going to do next and try to get out of here. Come on. What do you want to do? You want to give up without trying?
No.
We can let them do this to us?
No.
Lock up the United States Army?
No.
We're soldiers, ain't we?
Yeah.
Then we got to make a plan.
Yeah.
We'll carry the battle to them. Force them to expose their flanks.
We'll force them to expose their...
Look, Topher, what would Space Commander Connors do in a situation like this?
Well, he'd...
Yeah? Yeah?
He'd call it to reserves.
Right.
Yeah, only we don't have any.
Oh, yes, we do.
We do.
Where? Here. Right up here.
Then right there.
Now, wait a minute. We got brains, ain't we? And a brain is a pretty powerful weapon if you use it right.
Yeah, that's right.
All right. Now, those space gals said they communicated with those Vegemen by mental telep... telep... whatever it was, they used their minds.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, then. Come on. Let's go. So all we gotta do is concentrate our minds on a giant parsnip out there and force him to turn off the power that operates this electric cage.
Hypnotize him. Say, that might work.
Uh-huh. All right. Now, I want you to look him right in the eye.
Which eye?
The one next to the carrot. And let me do the rest. All right? Okay, now. Operation Tink. You, my friend, you are under my power. You are getting sleepy. Raise your right arm. I think I'm getting them, Philbrick. Raise your right foot. Now raise your left foot.
Get up, you meatball. I think I got him.
You, walk this way. This way, please. No, not that way. Hey, not that way. This way. Okay, pal. I'll have you out of there in a moment. Must have turned the house switch. Time? Whose side are you on anyway?
What happened to you when you disappeared?
I don't know, but you kept going on and off like a light yourself. Must be some kind of a mirror set up in this electrical pokey.
Well, what do we do now?
I don't know. Let's do something, even if it's wrong.
Listen, we've got to stop those overgrown space bunnies before they take off in that rocket ship. How are we going to do it?
I know how we can start.
Where?
With our feet. Let's go.
Everyone, it's lunchtime here on the Shove Boat. You love me special meal that peppery. This one is watercress au gratin. I hope you enjoy it.
Hey,
and over
please.
Here you like this. It's Pop-Tart sautéed in noodle roni. It's delicious.
Yeah.
I know you'll enjoy this stuff because only 3 people have died so far from the food. So you'll really, really enjoy it. Have a good time. And we've got Alka-Seltzer in the back for you. So I know that you'll really, really enjoy it. Step right up and make sure that you eat neatly. I don't want to clean this up after all. Yes, indeed. This is lovely.
Goliath, excuse me, but I keep handing out these lunches here. I have to go up, and I personally made this map for the captain, so he'll know where we're going to be going. And so I'm going to just give this to him and explain to him where we're going to go. Okay, would you hold on to this for me? Thanks.
Certainly. All right, everyone. While he goes up there, let's go up there and let's see what's happening here. Now you're supposed to eat it, sir. What do you think you'd do with it? You fool. I mean, really.
All right, Captain, this is the map I made, and I think that we should work from this map on the cruise.
What are you talking about? That can't possibly...
No, really, it's terrific. I made this map. Just... No, wait, don't throw it away.
Come on.
No, really, just follow this map perfectly. Boy, this is going to be great. Just trust me.
Coming up, Sven sings some seagoing barnacled blues.
This is ridiculous. Oh, man.
After paying full price for that blouse, how did you feel seeing it for half off?
Not happy.
Spiegel Outlet Store, the emotional outlet.
Listen, if you're ready to pick out new carpeting, we'd like to sell you some. Come on, pick a carpet, any carpet. Of course, with Empire, it isn't just any carpet. It's the very best brands and the very best values. Pick a credit plan, too. Bank card, American Express, or Empire's own plan. No installment payment for 60 days. Then pick your free gift, phone or shampoo. Call right now.
588-2300. Empire.
I really think it's gone on long enough, guys.
Here's what you should be doing instead of suffering from cramps. And you could, with the help of Maximum Cramp Relief Formula Pamprin. Maximum because each capsule has as much aspirin-free pain reliever as extra-strength Tylenol, plus a special cramp reliever. So get Maximum Cramp Relief Formula Pamprin and get out there.
Remodeling? The Tapper family at First City Builders says, let's make a deal. Behind curtain number one, the deal of the lifetime on bathroom remodeling at just $16 a month.
Behind curtain number two, a money-saving deal on beautiful new rec rooms, just $31 a month.
And behind curtain number three, a great deal on a dormer for added space, just $28 a month. Pick your deal and we'll meet or beat any other bidder, give you the difference in cash. Call First City Builders now, 583-8922, 583-8922.
The road to getting a high school diploma is long, and sometimes it seems to be all uphill. But don't give up, because high school graduates are winners in life. That's the kind of winner we're looking for. Maybe you can be one of us. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Back to the movie. Hey, Gup, what's your favorite entry?
Greg Kasperzik, who says, I wasted 25 cents on a chance to win a cruise on the Chicago River when I could walk on it for free. Huh?
I think we're lost.
I kind of figured that out.
Thank boots. Okay, let's rest.
Come on, let's go.
Let's duck in there just in case they're looking for us.
Sergeant Glory and the rest of the jerks. Hiya, fellas. Are we glad to see yous?
Hiya, fellas. What's the matter? Ain't you glad to see us?
Hey, he looks like a statue. That's because he's a sergeant.
Something wrong here, Philbrick. He's still breathing. You know what I think? Those girls put him in some kind of suspended anti-motion or whatever it is.
You mean they're zombies?
Yeah. I wonder if they can hear us.
No. I saw guys like this the movies once. The Living Dead.
Oh, don't do that.
Hey, now's my chance to tell a sergeant off without him talking back to me. Glory, you're real squares, Bill. Salute when you talk to a private. And look at those shoes. They're a mess.
Hey, but don't look around.
Did I hurt you, little footsies?
Hey, you never can trust these guys. And we better get out of here. Those Amazons probably miss us by now. Hey, fellas, we'll see you later. We're going for help.
Yeah.
Well, now which way do we go?
The Army manual says that when you get lost, you should find a tree with moss growing on the north side of the tree. So all we gotta do is find a tree. Then we stand with our backs to the tree, my left arm is facing east, my right arm is facing west, and I'm facing straight ahead.
Hold it.
Then all we have to do is stand with our backs to the tree, walk straight ahead, and that'll be north.
Hold it. Where are we gonna find trees down here?
Well, maybe we can find one of those Benjamin with moss growing on the north side.
There's only one thing to do.
What's that?
I don't know.
Well, maybe we should split up. One of us ought to go back and warn the colonel.
You don't think he's going to believe the story about galaxy gals and guys growing in flower pots? You think we're drunk?
It's the truth.
What if he doesn't believe us?
Well, then we'll get drunk.
Well, we got to do it. Because the whole world's at stake. You go that way, and I'll go this way.
Fancy running into you again.
Can't you ever do anything right?
Well, I got you out of that electrical pokey, didn't I?
Yeah, well, for your information, I was safer in there than out here with you. Now, why don't we take it nice and easy and just walk out? Let's go.
Wait a minute. Let's try it my way for a change.
Fortunate you were able to find your way back here. We thought you had been hurt and you wouldn't be able to accompany us on our journey through the black void of space.
Hey, put us down, will you?
I got it, Jim.
So you were going to take us with you, huh?
Gee, I always wanted to take a trip in a spaceship.
It will be very fascinating to see if your weak, inferior bodies will be able to withstand the strains and stresses of time warp travel.
Hey, why don't you go conquer some other world and leave us alone?
It isn't kind of you to talk that way. We're not really going to conquer your world. We're merely saving it from itself. The rate your world is going, it's going to destroy itself in another 200 or 300 years. It would be such a waste to allow a young planet to be destroyed simply because its natives were too stupid to work together.
Well, look, we don't look at it that way. And that part about us being slaves is no good. No good at all. Because, first of all, we're slaves for the Army now.
And that part about saving the world, that's no good either. Because we don't go for that baloney. And one more thing. One important thing. If we ever get away from you two, you're going to find out how strong we really are.
Ben, are you all right?
Yeah.
I think it would be better if we showed you how strong we are.
Hey, if those bums are so strong, why do they have to take orders from yous? If I was that strong, I'd bust out of here.
This is why. I don't suppose I have to tell you what this ray would do to an Earth body. Now I must get back to my final preparations for the trip back to our world. Oh, just in case you have any ideas about getting lost again, I'll leave Dr. Pona here to guard you.
Of Northern Bathroom Tissue, the tissue so soft you can see it, have just come up with another big new idea. New Northern Six Pack. Now you don't have to run out of softness. New Northern Six Pack.
You cook a beautiful meal. You want to put a price on it so everybody will come dig in. And Long John Silver's does.
Make the Long John Silver's great seafood escape.
It's a three-piece fish dinner.
We start with 1, 2, 3 crispy fish fillets, add hush puppies and fries and fresh... Where's the coleslaw?
Just made it.
Hey, out there, you can't drive past Long John Silver's three-piece fish dinner. That's a lot of good eating for the money.
Like an iceberg breaking away from the pack. Crashing into a chocolatey sea. Reappearing as Polar Bar. A gigantic block of Seal Test ice cream surrounded by a coating made with real milk chocolate. Polar Bar Ice Cream Squares. The treat of enormous proportions.
Katie, what have you done to my house?
What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. It's never smelled this clean before.
That's the Pine Sol signal. That fresh scent tells the world your house is more than clean.
How come?
Pine Sol does more than just clean. Pine Sol cleaner disinfectant cuts through grease, kills household germs and odors, and leaves a fresh scent
that shows you've cleaned the grease and killed the germs.
Pine Sol, an official sponsor of the U.S. track and field team.
I've got a show to put on, and you're supposed to be in that show.
Hey, there'll be other shows, right?
Question is, will you be around to be in them?
If there's one thing I've learned at the School of the Arts, it's that if you want people to get a message, you have to show them, not just tell them.
Sorry, I'm late.
You're not early or late. You're just fired.
Fame, tonight at 6 on Metro Media 32.
Okay, here's what we're going to do. We've got all the entries written down on these cards here, and Helen is going to hand them to me at random. These are our 45 winning entries. We're going to take as many of them as we can and make the My Summer Is So Miserable blues out of them, even as we speak. Ready? So, Doug, you ready to start?
Tell the story now, Spin. Tell the story.
Yeah, tell us about it, Spin.
Here we go.
Help me now. Help me.
Oh, my summer's so miserable that I think I'll get a job. Nah. I said my summer's so miserable.
Oh, yeah.
That I think that cruising with my Maverick through Berwyn while eating White Castle and listening to Wally Phillips.
Hi there.
Sounds like paradise
He gets some new mold hosiery, too. And that's why I say...
Tell the story now.
You know, my summer's so miserable.
I'm in the woods, brother.
I got married and moved to Indiana.
No, Indiana.
Not only that, but he says, I've got nothing better to do.
Nothing better to do.
Than learn my 9-digit zip code. You know my summer's so miserable.
How miserable has it been?
My carefully tended rock garden died.
Help
me now, help me. My summer's so miserable. I had no information. Just so I could get someone to talk to.
That man is lonely, yeah.
I say my summer's so miserable.
I said miserable.
I go out of dust. I don't let the mosquitoes bite me.
Yeah.
So I'll have something to do tomorrow.
What's that?
And that's scratch. You get a touch.
You know my summer's so miserable. I joined the Pia's Adora fan club.
Stay tuned as Sven meets the oldest and the youngest winners on Sven's summer sale.
Give me a book of baseball.
Oh, my swimsuit got wet. Now, wet is where my house.
Here comes Meadowlark Lemon. He's never tried Charmin. Watch me get him. Now.
I got it.
What is it? That's Charmin. Haven't you ever tried it?
No. Is it soft?
Squeeze it.
It is soft.
And
cushiony.
And
squeezable.
Gotcha. See? Just squeeze the Charmin.
Two.
And I gotcha.
Charmin. The squeezing gets you. The softness keeps you.
Oh, no. I forgot to add the fabric softener.
Oh, no. I forgot to add the fabric softener.
Solo detergent has fabric softener built in. It's a clean with a softness you can't forget. See the difference Solo softener can make. 10 muddy sweatshirts cleaned in regular liquid detergent. 10 in Solo. Both are clean, but Solo's clean is fluffed up higher.
Solo clothes are clean, soft, without static cling.
Oh.
Forget to add the fabric softener again?
No. I use Solo now.
Solo. It's a clean with a softness you can't forget.
When you want to eat well, but eat light, there are new Classic Light dinners. Complete meals to satisfy the most discriminating taste. With classic combinations like beef pepper steak, with rice and green beans in a light butter sauce, yet beyond their classic great taste. Classic Light dinners are less than 300 calories. Classic Light dinners from Armour. The classic way to eat light.
Bravo!
Most people can't help but help themselves from the most delicious brownies in the world, Duncan Hines. If you can't help but help yourself to the most delicious brownies in the world, Duncan Hines.
Of the leading mixes, Duncan Hines batter is the most smooth and creamy, which makes the most delicious the most delicious brownies.
So go ahead and help yourself.
You know you gotta help yourself, so go ahead and help yourself to the most delicious brownies in the world,
Duncan Hines.
Rockabye, you baby. Hi, I'm Harry Schmirler. You can buy a new Cutlass for $12,600 or a new Thunderbird with the same equipment for only $10,600 at Schmirler Ford. Just think, $2,000 less for a brand new Thunderbird only at Schmirler Ford. Cutlass is a great car, but when you see and drive the Thunderbird, you'll be convinced it's an even better car. The $2,000 you save makes it a great deal. Schmirler Ford is at Route 83 and Toohey in Elk Grove Village.
Invasion of the Star Creatures continues, and here's Durwood's favorite contest entry.
It's Michael Bodner who said, my summer's so miserable, I started to search for the meaning of life, cereal.
Point that gun at us.
Somehow you escaped our force field unit. I don't intend to take any more chances.
I'd like to take a chance with you.
How do you mean?
Hello, operator.
If you don't know, baby, you're real square.
Square?
Just my luck to meet a girl like this, and she's got a gun.
You'd better be quiet. I want to think, and you're disturbing me.
Well, do you mind if we talk to each other?
No, but I wouldn't consider escaping. I'm watching you.
Likewise.
Well, what do we talk about? The weather?
Yeah, whether we're going to get out of here or not. I got no eyes to end up a guinea pig on some bug-eyed planet.
I've got an idea. I'll sneak up behind her, and when I get her interested, you grab.
Grab what?
She's 7 feet tall. Well, get up on a chair. Then when you grab her, I'll get the gun.
Yeah, right between the eyes.
You're right. The idea's no good. The Army can't afford to lose a man like me. The idea's no good.
Yes, it is.
Why?
Because it's the only one we got. Now, you go over there and make like Sinatra. She might like that.
Sinatra? I can't sing.
Not that Sinatra. Irving Sinatra. He's a good-looking butcher from my neighborhood.
Be serious, Penn.
I am serious. I'll tell you what. Go over and imitate a French movie star. She might like that. Go ahead. Lots of luck.
J'attendais, j'attendais, j'attendais.
Don't point that gun at me. I can't talk with it staring me in the face.
All right. Now, what do you wish to say?
Let me take you away from all this, my cherie.
You're confused. We're taking you away. But what are you trying to say?
What I'm trying to say is, I go for you. You send me. You're cool. Haven't you ever heard of love?
Only through the minds of you Earth people. It puzzles me you devote so much time to the thinking of it.
Oh, we do more than think about it.
Just what is love?
A very stupid move on your part. Not very clever.
He wasn't trying anything honest. He was trying to help me show you what love is.
That is love.
Well, a part of it. He was trying to embrace you.
Embrace? Show me. That is embrace.
Well, something like that.
You mean you do it this way?
Oh, oh, now, let me down. You'll break my back. Oh! Boy, what a female wrestler you'd make.
If embrace is part of love, then it's painful, is that right?
No, it's not meant to be. Love can be pretty nice. Love is the way a boy feels about a girl.
Feels?
Well, I don't want to go into that. It's when a boy likes a girl a lot, wants to be near her all the time, wants to be with her, and wants to kiss her.
Kiss?
That's love.
Show me.
You might break my lips. Oh, no. All right, but the boys at the barracks will never believe this. First, you pucker your lips. Like this. And then I better get a chair.
I'm waiting.
You asked for it.
Hey, Silbrick, what's going on here?
Come on, Silbrick, break it up. Come on, you're embarrassing me. Man, you got a secret weapon. Those lips of yours are going to be classified as top security. Let's go. I think you blew out a couple of her fuses. Come on, snap out of it. This is our chance to get out of here before she comes to.
What happened?
You tell me, lover. She's out like a light.
Yeah. Yeah, who turned them out?
Are you okay?
Yeah. Let's go.
Come on, let's go. This is our chance to get out of here.
Yeah, we're lost again.
You know what I'm going to do if I ever get out of here, Pan?
It's probably very ridiculous, but I'll bite. What are you going to do if we ever get out of here?
I'm going to try out for the Olympics as a marathon runner.
I thought so.
There's a terrible draft in a stupid cave. I can't get my cigar lit.
Here, try this.
Thanks.
What did you say?
I didn't say anything honest. I only said thanks.
No, before that.
There is a terrible draft in a stupid cave. I can't get my...
That's it. If there's a draft, it's got to be coming from someplace and going someplace. And not only that, it's got to be coming from the outside and going outside. Here, give me this. There, you see? Now, all we got to follow this flame there, and that's it. It's better than having a compass.
Gee, I'll bet that's one that Space Commander Connors hadn't even thought of. Imagine using a cigarette lighter as a compass. We ought to get that idea patented. Let's go, brain.
To get her for 35 years. Then suddenly last night, Herbert kicked the bucket.
People everywhere are kicking the bucket for the great taste of Church's fried chicken. Church's chicken is bigger than Kentucky Fried, and you always get Church's at a deliciously low price.
Church's chicken is delicious. Herbert, you should kick the bucket years ago.
Now, any combination, pies, fries, slaw, 4 for 99 cents when you buy a family order.
Summertime blues.
Nestle Toll House pan cookies and ice cream. A summer treat you bake in a pan in 20 minutes with Nestle Toll House morsels.
Cool. Easy. Yummy. Fun.
Nestle Toll House pan cookies and ice cream.
Mom got the cure for the summertime blues.
I don't believe this.
An experiment that should never have happened 41 years ago.
We opened up a hole in time, and it stayed open.
Is still going on.
Good Lord, there it is.
The Philadelphia experiment.
Somehow we got moved in time.
He is the only survivor of a journey through time.
What's the date? The year.
Kidding? It's 1984.
This is hurting.
That's him.
Pick him up.
But time is running out.
Now, we can't stop it, but I believe that you can.
I gotta go.
Good luck, sailor.
Go!
Michael Paré, Nancy Allen, The Philadelphia Experiment with Future.
Now playing, consult your local newspaper.
Get your sights to the stars with On Stage America. First, Connie Francis shares her real-life drama. Comic Gary Chandling and his special brand of comedy. From Star Search, Penny Mealing shares her greatest fear. It's a birthday spectacular with Victor Borga. Plus, Southern comfort music from Alabama. Then, the great Julius LaRosa makes a dramatic return. Plus, the Temptations are ready to tell you their story. All On Stage America.
Tonight at 7 on Metro Media 32. Back to Invasion of the Star Creatures and Ann Landers' favorite entry.
Robert Smolik, who says, my summer is so miserable, I'm considering declaring myself a political prisoner so Jesse Jackson can negotiate my release.
Look. What? Over there. I hope they didn't see us.
Oh, I don't know if they saw us or not.
But they're coming this way. What are we going to do?
I got an idea. I saw a trick in a cowboy picture once. We'll pile all these rocks up here, and when they start up the hill, we'll roll them down on those freaks.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, let's start shoving. That's impossible.
Well, it sure looks like that trick didn't work.
Yeah. Well, in that case, there's only one thing to do.
Right.
What's the use of running? We're only going to tire ourselves out. Eventually, it'll catch up with us.
What do we do?
We're going to fight him.
We're going to fight him.
We're going to fight him.
We're going to fight him? We're going to fight them?
That's right. We're going to stay right here and fight him.
We can't do that. They're too big and strong for us.
Then we're going to outsmart them, Slugger. That's right. They may be bigger and stronger than us, but they think slow and they move slow. So we're going to use our size and our minds to an advantage. See, and our speed to an advantage, too. What do you think of that, Slugger? And I'm not going to leave you here. I think we got a better chance over there at that clearing. Come on, Slugger. Let's go. Now, you understand what we're going to do, huh?
I think so.
I hope so. Here they come.
Go!
Hey!
Hey, come on, you!
Oh, come on! Stop!
You made a hit!
Hey!
Hey, stay in the nose! Come on, Ed!
Oh! You!
Thank you.
me now, please. Hey, come on, pull me now, will you? Hey, stop, will you? No, no, please, oh, no. Man, leave me alone, will you, please? Please, I'll do anything you want. I'll water you every day, I'll pull your weeds, but please leave me alone, Mr. Benjamin. Please, please. Hey, it's you.
Hey, Pam, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. But in another minute, boy, they would have clobbered us.
Oh, I don't know. I'd just get warmed up, boy.
Hey, listen, Philbrick. You know why those Benjamin stopped working us over? They were called back to the cave by those space broads. Yeah, by telepathy. You know what that means.
Yeah, we can keep on breathing.
No, 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 dopey. It means our rocket ship is ready to take off, and we gotta stop them.
Well, good idea. You go stop them. I'll go warn the colonel.
Are you nuts? Don't you know what he'd do? He'd think we're drunk and throw us in the guardhouse.
Not the colonel. He's smart. He'd know what to do.
Throw them in the guardhouse!
The colonel!
Vegetable man, space women, poppycock. What do you take me for? Don't you answer that. And where are the rest of my men?
They're back in the cave. Them space broads made zombies out of them.
Now I've heard everything. Wait till I get my hands on that Sergeant Glory. Where did you get that stuff you've been drinking? We could use some of that in the officers' club. Much too good for you enlisted men. Huh, I could stand a good belt right now.
But we're not drunk. I swear it, sir. The army has got to stop that spaceship before it takes off.
Not my army. And if you weren't a private, Philbrick, I'd bust you. The army works on logic, and an officer follows regulations. There's no way in the world you could convince me this fantastic story is true.
It is true, sir. I swear it. On my Space Commander Connor's secret ring.
On your what?
On my Space Commander Connor's secret ring.
That'll be all, guard. You can go. I'll handle this situation myself. I see you're in. Alpha?
Saturn, rocket,
Finn! Cast off!
Blast off!
Space pals to the end! What stellar squadron are you in?
Stellar squadron, Centurion 6.
That's my squadron.
Then may I remind you of Section 3-4 of Space Commander Connor's secret handbook for rocket men?
Here it is. Section 3-4.
Assistance is asked of a fellow squadron member by another member of the same squadron. It is the duty of that squadron member to render every aid to his brother officer until the emergency is overcome.
Then I'm asking you, fellow Stellar Squadron Centurion 6 officer, for your assistance in destroying that spaceship before it destroys the Earth.
Oh, but Philbrick,
do I have to report your refusal to Space Commander Connor?
No, not that. My record is perfect.
Well, what is your rank? Stella, comrade.
I am a junior flight leader.
And I am a senior flight leader. So you will take orders from me. This is crazy. This is mad. What are you talking about? It's mad.
See, one of us.
Just a volunteer. But we're wasting time. Prepare to blast off the scene of emergency.
Yes, sir, senior flight leader.
Attention!
Forward! March!
Hut! 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 Hut!
Headquarters, Colonel Awol's office. No, General. The Colonel just left in his space helmet. Space helmet?
Oh, well, you know it's time once again for you. You've been enjoying this movie, haven't you? I'll bet you have. And remember, you can write to me at the address you see right here on your screen, somewhere down below there. And I did want to mention, we have the oldest and youngest winners of our Sven Summer Sale contest right here. This is Heather, Heather Stewart. Heather, would you tell us what your entry was? Your summer is so miserable that...
The Alan Thicke Show is becoming my favorite late-night TV show.
Let's hear it for Heather and Alan Thicke here. How old is Heather? How old are you?
12 years old.
12 years old. Our youngest winner, our oldest winner, even though she doesn't look it, is Violet Pepler. Violet, how old are you?
60.
60 years? Do you believe this woman is 60 years old?
Oh, no.
I don't believe it. No. And Violet, your entry was really pretty funny. I think it was one of our funniest ones. Would you mind repeating it for the folks at home and the people on the boat?
Well, it was a pretty bad summer. My sons gave me a toy poodle for my 60th birthday, and I killed it putting the batteries in.
Putting the batteries in. That's wonderful. These are our oldest and youngest. I got that order right. Okay. And hit the theme, Ken.
Thank you for all the stars and letters you post in Television Land.
Here's what you should be doing instead of suffering from cramps. Could, with the help of Maximum Cramp Relief Formula Pamprin. Maximum because each capsule has as much aspirin free pain reliever as extra strength Tylenol, plus a special cramp reliever. So get Maximum Cramp Relief Formula Pamprin and get out there.
Summer, summer fruits, it wouldn't be summer without them.
Nothing says summer like fresh California peaches.
Fresh from the tree, taste them and see.
So sweet and juicy. California peaches taste as good as summer fields. You won't want to miss them this summer.
Nature's way of smiling, sunshine on a tree.
It's peak of the season for California peaches.
You cook a beautiful meal. You want to put a price on it so everybody will come dig in. And Long John Silver's does.
It's the Long John Silver's great seafood escape.
It's our three-piece fish dinner.
We start with 1, 2, 3 crispy fish fillets, add hush puppies and fries and fresh... Where's the coleslaw?
Just made it.
Hey, out there, you can't drive past Long John Silver's three-piece fish dinner. That's a lot of good eating for the money.
I forgot to add the fabric softener.
Solo detergent has softener built in. It's a clean with a softness you can't forget. See the difference Solo softener can make. Two piles of 10 sweatshirts. Both are clean, but Solo's clean is fluffed up higher.
Solo clothes are clean, soft, without static cling.
Oh.
Forget to add the fabric softener again?
No, I use Solo now.
Solo, it's a clean with a softness you can't forget.
At Marshall Fields, our buyers are proud of their fashions and accessories, so it's not easy for them to accept
50 to 75% off the original price.
The final clearance of the season. To see all their hard work reduced to
$19.99.
And while our buyers aren't thrilled about 50 to 75% markdowns, you will be. After all, their loss can be your gain. Don't miss Marshall Fields' final sales and clearances.
Back to the movie and Mr. Rogers' favorite entry.
It's from our neighbor, Mr. Gagarino. He says his summer is so miserable, the highlight of the evening is watching test patterns on TV. Is that fun?
Hey, Philbrick. Philbrick, don't you think you're making the space commander bit go just a little too far?
We're saving the world, ain't we?
Saving the world? You don't think we get back to that cave that phony ring is going to work on those space Amazons, do you?
Phony ring? That's treason. I'll have you space marshal.
Well, if we're supposed to be spacemen, how come we're acting like the infantry?
Why don't you wamp us up an air taxi or flying belts or something? I'm getting blisters on my blisters.
You're soft, that's all, you're soft.
Yeah, I'm soft, soft in the head.
Remember the Space Commander Connor's creed.
When the going gets tough and it looks like it's going to get tougher, that's the time to show the stuff that makes us tough and show the world we're rougher.
You mean to tell me they got all that on one box top?
Hey, look! You fellas see what I see?
Hey, the 7th Cavalry to the rescue.
They're obviously Indians.
I know, but maybe they can help anyway.
Hey, Kemosabe! You guys, wait a minute! Hey, Sitting Bull, over here. I want to buy some blankets.
Hey, Philbrick.
Hold it.
Let me do the talking. You might goof things up.
A senior flight leader's not in the habit of goofing up a military situation. For some reason, you bug me, Sergeant, and I suggest you remember your status as a volunteer and blast down.
Okay. I was just trying to help.
Hey, look, you guys. Now, we need your guys to come with us very badly, because you got to come with us to help stop that rocket ship from taking off. Now, do you understand what I mean? Don't you guys know what I'm saying?
Undoubtedly, some tribe that thinks the white man didn't win the West thinks we were defeated with Custer.
Custer! Custer! Team Custer!